And I realized the reality of what was happening. You know, this is an 87-year-old man who is losing everything around him.
Yeah, that Charlotte County man there barely spoke English and was battling dementia. And when he was about to lose his home, the community stepped in. In tonight's cover story, ABC7's Jeff Harris is showing us how music became the life-saving language.
An elegant, calm, soothing sound. To be honest, it's something you would hear at a concert. It turns out, back in 1968, you would have.
When you walked in the door and you see this frail man who's a concert pianist who has traveled the world, played piano for presidents and queens.
But so few people know about the man who puts on a collared shirt, straightens his tie, and throws on a suit jacket every time he sits down at the piano.
It's absolutely touched us all.
Meet Ziggy, just Ziggy, an 87-year-old Northport man with limited English, onset dementia, and a heart too big to measure.
There's a closeness, definitely, with Ziggy.
Up until about a month ago, Ziggy was enjoying retirement in his Charlotte County trailer, playing piano every day.
Well, unfortunately, when growth happens, sometimes we have unintended consequences, and Ziggy became one of those unintended consequences.
Earlier in the fall, business developers bought the piece of land where Ziggy lives. They went door to door, letting the residents know by mid-December they needed to move out.
They never took the time to speak in Polish and make sure that he really understood what was going on.
So even with trailers being demolished and the utilities getting shut off, Ziggy didn't know he had to move. He didn't understand.
He started collecting water from the Myakka River and was using this as his drinking water, using this to wash his dishes, using this to wash his body.
Plain and simple, Ziggy needed help. So in came Justin Willis and Care Patrol.
It's our job to step up for our community. It's important. It's what we should be doing.
With only a week to find a new home, Justin, along with several local business owners, started a GoFundMe page.
All in all, we raised just about $28,000 over a 7-day period.
They acted quickly, got the paperwork done, and found Ziggy a new trailer, fully stocked. But Justin and his wife, Christine, couldn't just hand Ziggy the keys. They knew this man, this bond they had formed in just under 2 months, was going to last forever.
We're here for him in every way that we can be. This is what family does.
I see him as a grandparent.
A new year, new home, and new family, with likely some new holiday traditions on the way.
He's a part of our family. I'm pretty sure I'll be kidnapping him for Christmas and Thanksgivings moving forward.
In Charlotte County tonight, Jeff Harris, ABC 7.